Speed welcomes you on a beautiful late spring afternoon. It is time for NASCAR Sprint Cup Series qualifying at the Richmond International Raceway. The official race title, the Crown Royal, presents the Heath Calhoun 400. And in case you're wondering about the name, I think it's worthy to let you know that Crown Royal, the title sponsor of the race, is honoring an injured war veteran. His name is Heath Calhoun, and he is here at the Richmond International Raceway, as are these fans. I'm glad you're with us here on Speed. Now, let's talk about our menu before we get into Sprint Cup Series qualifying at Richmond, Virginia. The NASCAR Hall of Fame biography, which is an outstanding series tonight, honoring Junior Johnson. That is at 10 Eastern, and on trackside, following the Junior Johnson Hall of Fame biography, Casey Kane and David Reagan, as you'll see Casey Kane has a surprise tribute to Darrell Waltrip, who won his last championship here in 1985. Now, let's take a look, prior to qualifying, who was quick in final practice. Jeff Gordon, 32 starts here, 22 top tens. He's led over 1,500 laps here at Richmond International. Fourth quick, also a Chevrolet, Juan Pablo Montoya. Montoya fourth overall. Third quick, a Toyota driver. It is Joey Logano driving for Joe Gibbs Racing in the Home Depot Toyota. A lot of drivers talking about how slick this racetrack was in both practices. Second quick, also a Toyota driver, but this one belonging to Michael Waltrip. David Ruderman, second quick in his Aaron's Dream Machine, and fastest, not a surprise at all. That honor goes to Kyle Busch. Now, Busch, in 10 starts here, has a win, and the most remarkable number for Busch, 8 top 5 finishes for the driver of that M&M's Toyota for Joe Gibbs Racing. As we take a look at the rest of the top 10, Greg Biffle, talked to his crew chief, Greg Irwin, a little bit earlier today. Not their best track, but they feel like they've made progress. Carl Edwards, a Roush Fenway teammate. Kurt Busch, Scott Speed, and Jeff Burton, all three RCR drivers, have won here at Richmond International. With that, let's go down pit side and join Bob Dillner prior to qualifying.
Well, Steve Burns, the drivers are starting to make their way out. We got the Furniture Row driver, Regan Smith, here. Had a great run going at Talladega, and then poof, up went the engine. But I know you want a good qualifying run here today. You were in the top 10 for a while, but how things shake out and what's the outlook for qualifying?
We got slid back at the end a little bit, but you know, we made some good changes on the car for qualifying here, and we'll see where we end up. I think that race trim, we were pretty happy with the car a little while ago. So guys on the Furniture Row Chevy been doing a really good job and working hard, and you know, we want to have a good run this weekend to make up for last week, and that was pretty disappointing to have such a fast race car and just have some bad luck there.
You still get butterflies going out and qualifying for a place like Richmond because it's so greasy and hot and sticky out there.
Well, now that you remind me about all that, no, you know, it. I watched some tapes from last year, and there was a couple cars that went real early that were real quick last year, too. So, you know, I'm not quite as concerned about that as I am just making sure to hit all my marks and do my job.
All right, Regan Smith going out to qualifying. We're going to sneak around here right now. We found somebody that's actually just hiding out a little bit, and that's a driver of the number 5 car, Mark Martin. Mark just chilling out here right before qualifying, and he's got a big old smile on his face. Mark, how excited are you for qualifying? How good is this number 5 car?
Well, the car was pretty good in race trim. We were pretty far down the sheet in Q trim, but you never know, you know, what kind of lap you're going to get or whatever. So, you know, we ran good in both races here last year. Sure look forward to racing, getting this HendrickCars.com Chevy up front.
Really hot here today. How greasy is this racetrack?
Wow. I've never seen it this slick off the corner. Really spinning the tires today. Different than I've ever seen it. So it's going to be interesting. It's a lot of fun. Man, everybody loves coming racing here, Richmond, so it should be a great show.
And that is true. I mean, every single driver, Steve Burns, loves coming here to Richmond because this is a short track that believes it's a big track, and there's always plenty of excitement, especially in qualifying.
17 top 5 finishes, Bob, for Mark Martin in 48 starts. It's a pretty sparkling record.
Definitely a sparkling record, but you know, there's a lot of rivalries building, and Steve, we've been talking about this all week long. There's some paybacks that some people owe some people, and this is the type of racetrack where you can pay people back. So I'm really looking forward to tomorrow night. You got Jeff Gordon, Jimmy Johnson. Of course, they've had milk and cookies. They've made up, supposedly. You got, you know, Greg Biffle and Joey Logano from earlier this year. So there's plenty of stuff going on to keep an eye out on here on the action track.
All right. Thank you very much, Bob Dillner. You see Jimmy Johnson's car in the inspection area in the garage area. Well, this is the 10th race of this 2010 season, the 108th race on this Richmond International Raceway for the NASCAR Sprint Cup Series teams. See Kurt Busch, Dale Earnhardt Jr.'s crew at the ready, as is Martin Truex Jr. We will take a break here on Speed from the Richmond International Raceway. When we come back, Mike Joy, Darrell Waltrip, and Larry McReynolds have qualifying for you.
Richmond International Raceway, where it's been hot and sunny all day through 3 hours of practice. Who has it dialed in best for NASCAR Sprint Cup Series qualifying presented by Subway? It's been a picture perfect day, a little on the warm side, and that's nice to see here in Richmond. 85 degrees, a light breeze, sunny, and no rain in the forecast for this evening or for tomorrow night. That's good news for the Heath Calhoun 400. Hi, everybody. Mike Joy, Larry McReynolds, Darrell Waltrip. As we look toward qualifying, do you like somebody with a late draw, a Jeff Gordon or a Clint Bowyer perhaps, or somebody else stand out for this pole run?
Well, I think we can always pick the favorites, you know, the guys that qualify up front. But I think, like we've seen in some of the other short tracks, there's always those surprises. Who would have thought A.J. Allmendinger would have won the pole at Phoenix? If you get the right air pressure and the right tires, and you go at the right time, it might all work out for you.
Well, and I think that's one reason, you know, we have surprises in these type of qualifying sessions because, Mike, you mentioned it. We had 3 hours of practice right in the heat of the day. Now the sun's starting to go down. It's starting to get twilight. And I don't know that we know who is the real favorite to sit on his pole. Yeah, Kyle Busch was fastest in practice. He just qualified his Nationwide Series car on the pole for that race later on tonight. You would tend to think he may be the favorite, but I like Phoenix. I think we'll have a little bit of a surprise.
When the sun goes down, the speeds go up.
All right, let's join Dick Bergeron.
With Joey Logano, who was third quick in practice, how about it? Is tonight's pole belong to you?
It could happen. I was talking to the guys in the trailer before I came out here, and Shaq seems to pick up a lot of speed when it comes to qualifying, and Shaq temp went down a little bit, I'm sure. So we're going to see if we can find a little bit more speed with the Home Depot Toyota. We're third quick in practice, so I think the car is good. I just got to find a little bit more. In race trim, the car is good, too. So. It's got a decent starting position. I think we got a shot at the pole, so we'll go for it and see what we turn out with.
Good deal. Krista Avoda.
Martin Truex, it's a tale of two Napas, qualifying versus race trim. How's your car?
Well, it's like you said, we were really pretty happy with our Napa Toyota and race trim. We ran some really good laps. The car had good speed and seemed to hold on, and on the lap tracker it looks real good. But we went to qualifying trim and it just really couldn't get the car hooked up, couldn't get the front end turning, and so we struggled with that a little, but Pat's made some changes, and usually the track picks up a good bit of speed here from practice, so we'll just hope we can pick up enough.
Thanks, Martin.
A.J. Allmendinger, the Valvoline 4, to be the first qualifier on track, brushed the wall during practice. This will be his seventh Richmond appearance.
Didn't hurt the car too bad. They got it back out pretty quickly, but he certainly wasn't very happy about getting into the wall that little bit.
Yeah, he was eighth quickest in the first practice, and then he was 17th quickest when final practice was all said and done. First lap, there it is, 21:53. So already A.J. Allmendinger on lap one is almost 2/10 quicker than the fastest speed of those 2 hour-and-a-half practice sessions.
His best previous start here, 13th. That was the first time he came here when he was with the Red Bull Toyota team. Second lap is quicker. That's what we expect almost every car to be. The 21:46 for Allmendinger. Here's our Toyota Sponsifier track description of the 3/4 mile Richmond International Raceway with a fairly steep 14 degree banking.
Yeah, the steep banking in the corner, certainly on the straightaways a little bit down the back 2 degrees, but look at that back straightaway. I mean, that's just a blurb. You come off turn two, you're in the throttle for about a second, and then you're in the third turn.
And you're turning the wheel almost the entire way around. It's just a little bit of straight back straightaway like you're talking about.
Not much chance to rest on this racetrack. It is a very very tiring racetrack, believe it or not, even though it's small.
18 Richmond starts for Kurt Busch. One victory. It came in his last drive here for Jack Roush. Six top 10 finishes, four in the last six races in the Blue Deuce.
He was eighth quickest in that final practice session. Made a practice qualifying very late in the practice. See like what he can do on
like
lap
the way one. That thing looked. I know one. He was eating that bottom up.
57 on his first lap.
Not quite as quick as A.J. Allmendinger was on his first lap.
Kurt comes in here seventh in the points. He wobbled there.
Yeah. He got up off the bottom of the, got back on the throttle. Maybe just a little too quick. Got the car up to hill a little bit, got a little loose.
He picked the throttle up good, though, off of turn four that time, and I think it's going to be good enough.
No.
No. 4/1000ths of a second slower than A.J. Allmendinger.
And here's why.
I know where he lost it. He gets back in the throttle a little early, gets the car pushing up the hill. He tries to, you know, stay in it, obviously, but that little wiggle is what cost him.
Very well could be those 4/1000ths.
That little wiggle looked like Jamie McMurray last Sunday at Talladega.
Just a little wiggle.
Just that little wiggle.
That's all it takes.
Now, here's a dude who's pretty fast in practice after overhauling his race car.
David Ruderman in the Aaron's Toyota. This will be his seventh race at Richmond. He gained three spots in the points to 27th last week with his 14th place finish in Talladega.
I think he was thinking about just leasing this car when he got here, but after a while working on it, he decided he'd buy it.
So it's a rent-to-own?
Yeah, rent-to-own.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah, I think he just wanted to give it away in that first practice session, but this looks like a pretty good first lap for David.
You got that right.
How about 21:32 on that's on lap one?
Right to the top of the board.
Rudy Tootie.
We have 46 cars here, which means there's 11 in knockout qualifying and no past champion for the eight positions available.
Larry, he is sailing that thing off in the corner, especially the third turn there. He really poured it in there.
But no quicker. He is 4/1000 slower than his first lap.
Two real good laps, though.
Dick Bergren.
Dinger, did the shunt with the wall affect the behavior of the car?
No, I mean, everybody worked hard on the Valvoline Ford today. It was a tough day for us. We were struggling. There was times we thought we were really good, and there was times we thought we were a little bit off. And, you know, I didn't help the race team by getting the wall. So they worked hard. Sorry to those guys and everybody for making them work too hard. And we'll see. The track had a lot of grip. I didn't get everything out of lap. I messed up just a little bit. So if that's in the top 20, I'll be happy with it.
All right, good deal. Thanks.
Greg Biffle in 3M Ford, third in the standings, 15 Richmond races, and one pole, three front row starts here.
Darrell, that's probably one negative to going early. It's not the lack of grip that the track might have or not have. It's not knowing how much it really does have, like A.J. just alluded to.
Yeah, some of these early teammates go out. They can come back in and talk to their teammates and say, you know, track had a lot of grip. Maybe a little air out of a tire, a little air in a tire can really make a huge difference in qualifying.
Looks like Biffle's going to miss it by about 3/10 here. 21:60 the first lap. The second lap is slower. So Biffle, fourth of four, with Paul Menard and Regan Smith coming up. Speed's coverage of NASCAR Sprint Cup qualifying from Richmond is presented by Subway Restaurants. So many $5 footlong subs to choose from. Enjoy amazing value at Subway all day, every day. And brought to you by Honda Generators, the power of choice. And by the Sponsifier, visit toyotaracing.com and click on Design It, Enter It. Paul Menard dropped one spot in the standings to 19th after Talladega. He was one of 25 cars involved in one of the wrecks there. And this will be his seventh trip to Richmond.
Yeah, he has struggled these last three races after having all top 20 finishes in the first six races of 2010. Not sure this qualifying run is going to be exactly what he's looking for either.
Sometimes, Larry, you know, when you have the offseason, you can get all your stuff, all your ducks in a row, and you come out strong. But the way this schedule is laid out, when you once hit into that racing every week and testing and everything else, sometimes it takes its toll on your results on Sunday.
So Menard is fourth of five with a 21:59. Dick?
David Ruderman, second quick in practice, right now on top of the board. But when I said congratulations, you looked up at the sky. What's on your mind?
Well, it's just, you know, that
that big ball in the sky there is going to get a little lower and going to give it a little bit of shade, and the track shade's going to pick up. And, you know, this place is pretty really, really temperature sensitive. But proud of my guys. It gave me a great Airstream machine. And we just have to see. You know, we had an early draw. We just have to see where it ended up putting us.
David Rudiman began his big league NASCAR career right here at Richmond, and he has run well today.
Thanks, Dick. Regan Smith, the Furniture Row Chevy, 2008 Rookie of the Year. His best qualifying effort this year, 20th at Bristol. This is his fourth race at Richmond.
Felt so bad for him last week at Talladega. He actually had a good little race car, led some laps, and then the engine expired on his 78 car.
Where you really make the time around this racetrack is right there. Getting up out of turn two, getting out of that hole, coming up on that back straightaway under power and not get the back end snapping out on you. That's where you really make a lot of good time.
If he used all of his up on lap one, he's fourth quickest at a 21:56, slows down just a little bit on lap two.
That's interesting, Darrell. Three drivers have their best lap on the second lap, three on the first lap. Worry on that just a little as we go to Kristen.
Well, walking along with teammates Denny Hamlin and Kyle Busch, and if I can squeeze in here, I know Denny's whole goal last night was that you did not win his charity event. So how mad is he going to be if you get the pole here today?
I don't know. I don't think he'd be too upset. He's got a good car too, so we'll see. But our M&M's Camry's been good so far today, and look forward to trying to go and try to get another pole here. But we'll see how hard it's going to be with what kind of lap times are being put up.
Thanks, Kyle.
Mark Martin in the HendrickCars.com number 5 has been racing at Richmond since 1981 when he started from the pole in his first ever cup race here.
Mark was always been a good qualifier, and particularly on the short tracks.
Yeah, I think in 81 he ran about 4 or 5 races and sat on a couple of poles, I think, that year out of the 4 or 5 races he started.
And those were his own cars, built them himself.
Right. Remember, he raced 81, 2, and 3, and then was out of the sport for 4 years before coming back with Jack Roush in 1988.
Crew chief was Banjo Grimm, I think his name was.
That's right.
Young kid.
First lap was a 21:52, picks it up about a half a tenth, makes him second quickest at 21:45.
Very nice.
Mark has 4 poles here, including his 49th career pole.
Car's pretty good. Did some wiggling, but you did an awesome job with it.
Always cheerleading after a qualifying run, especially. Normally he's pretty fast.
So as two of the Gibbs teammates look on, here's driver 88. Dale Earnhardt Jr. had a good practice in the National Guard Chevrolet. And he has one front row start here in 21 appearances.
Exciting announcement yesterday over Dale Earnhardt Day at DEI. Dale's birthday, and they announced he's going to run the 3 car with Wrangler at Daytona in the nationwide race. Big deal.
Yes, it will. Darrell, what I saw with this run here, his car just was kind of in a four-wheel slide through 1 and 2, and I think the tracker pretty much reflects it. 21:71 on that first lap.
Got his work cut out on this lap. Sometimes slide around like that, the air pressure builds up and you just go slower.
Just didn't get a good drive off too, Darrell.
Nope. That's a killer corner.
Yeah, he's working on being the slowest of our 8 cars. Got off turn 4, and that definitely picked him up quite a bit to a 21:54, just enough to bump him up to 5th.
Coming up, Martin Truex, Joey Logano. David Rudiman, Mark Martin, quickest so far is the Napa Toyota for Martin Truex Jr. It's the track. 15th in the standings, he gained 2 spots at Talladega and has 5 top 8 starts here in 8 Richmond races.
Car was really slow through the center of 1 and 2 on that first lap. It just didn't want to turn right in there. The car just gets really slow, like he can't get the front end to grip.
Much better this time. Eases it into 3 a bit.
Gonna pick back up a little bit here.
A little bit's a lot right now.
Playing strong around off the corner. 6th. With a 21:54.
He picked up a half a tenth, picked up about 3 spots.
21:54 right there. 20.
So Truex is 6th.
Good.
And here is Joey Logano in the Home Depot Toyota. Finished in the top 10 in both of his nationwide starts at Richmond. Finished top 20 in both of his cup races in his rookie season last year. Pole winner at Bristol, led 9 laps at Talladega, but got caught up and dropped to 16th in the points.
Sounded fast when he went by here, I can tell you that.
He was very confident when we talked to him about this car. He was third quickest in that final practice. I don't think it's going to come close on lap one. We'll have to see what happens on lap two. 21.63, that puts him, or 57 puts him eighth quickest.
See what kind of air pressure a Zippy put him out there on. If you put that pressure down just a little wee bit, that first lap won't be all that great. Kind of hoping that that car will come in on the second. Let's see if it does or not.
It's going to be better than lap one, but it will not be a pole run. He's going to go to fifth quickest to a 53.
Travis Quappel and Matt Kenseth are next. Tonight on Speed, the incredible story of Junior Johnson, NASCAR Hall of Fame inductee, who went from moonshine runner to become one of NASCAR's greatest. Tonight, 10 p.m. Eastern, only on Speed, NASCAR Hall of Fame biography, Junior Johnson. Travis Quappel in the Long John Silver's Ford, 21.73, slowest of the 11 drivers thus far. Krista?
Well, a lot of folks are probably doing backflips when they see this retro Budweiser look, including DW up in the booth. Talk about your paint scheme today, Casey.
Yeah, it's kind of cool to run. This is a paint scheme from the 1985 Budweiser Darrell Waltrip championship year. So it was, you know, it's pretty cool to do it on our Budweiser Ford. And Darrell won here that year at Richmond. So hopefully we can run well. We're a little bit off in practice, ended up 12th, and made a few more changes. So we'll see how this goes. We got a pretty decent draw. Hopefully it'll work out for us.
All right, thanks, DW. I know you think it looks good, right?
I really do. Chris, I always loved that hood on that car when with the big bud on the hood. You could look back in the field, and whether we're leading or back in the field a bit, you could always pick her out. I like that.
Matt Kenseth, fourth in the standings, fifth on the board after that first lap, has one top 10 start this year. That was at Bristol.
Oh, now. Whoop. See, you had it going on there for a second, but then a little tail happy.
That's an awfully good first lap for Matt.
A strong second lap. Is it quicker? 21.504. Not quite. Kevin Conway and Jamie McMurray coming up next. Speed's coverage of NASCAR Sprint Cup qualifying from Richmond brought to you by Toro. Count on it. By New Finish Kling Instant Detailer, the shine that sticks. And by Tornadoes, bold is how we roll. Lynchburg's Kevin Conway in the Extends Ford, running at the end of all of his eight races in 2010. And he is 13th of 13, a 22-22 on both laps.
Getting that good seat time, Larry. He's learning. He's a rookie. He's getting there.
And I'd say, based on the first nine races, he will be running at the end of this race tomorrow night.
And I say, by the second time we go around in the series, I think he'll be a little bit better.
Jamie McMurray, the Bass Pro Shops Tracker Boat Chevrolet, 17th in the standings with that runner-up finish at Talladega. He gained three spots. 14 Richmond races. Never has he led a lap here.
I remember him having a really good run in the Nationwide Series car about the time that Chip Ganassi hired him the first go around to go over there.
Had a very bad first turn on that first lap. Let's see if he can crowl her up a little bit here. Lost a lot of time getting down into turn one.
But I tell you what, he let that thing roll through the middle in one and two, and then when he picked it up, he was able to stay in it hard.
Yeah, I think he just overdrove it the first time in there. He's much better this time. Let's see what he does.
Rudiman's a 21.32. Second, 21.40.
You know, Darrell, we were talking at commercial break. I believe you run a low 40 and be in good shape. You're on a high 50, you're going to be way back there.
Rudiman's got about a tenth on there, but let's just 21.40, 45, 46, 46, 52, 53, 54, 54, 59, 59. That's the top 10.
For all your NASCAR news, Monday through Thursday, 7:30 p.m., it's NASCAR Race Hub right here on Speed. You never know who's going to stop by, so why don't you? Kevin Harvick, the Talladega winner with one of the most perfectly timed moves in the history of motorsport.
It's kind of ironic that there were 29 lead changes.
29 leaders.
Our leaders.
Yeah.
And he was the 20.
And there were
one of the 29.
A Dale Jr. number of lead changes.
Yes.
Going to be a pretty good first lap for Kevin Harvick. He's second quickest at a 21:40. You know, I don't think we've given Kevin enough credit for everything he's done. Of course, one of them is going to come to an end this weekend. He's not going to be in the NASCAR Camping World Truck Series race in Kansas. But right now, as we speak, he's in the top five in points in all three of the top series.
He's had a whale of a start to this season, that's for sure.
Second lap is a tick slower, a 55 to a 40. So it's Rudiman, Harvick, McMurray, and Mark Martin. Coming up, Brad Kay and Denny Hamlin. Brad Keselowski will be the 16th driver to take time in the Penske Dodge. Four straight finishes of 16th or better before Talladega, where he wound up 34th.
Pretty sporty looking lap here too.
Second.
Oh yeah.
38.
Rudiman's getting a little nervous now. That's a 38 to his 32. They're inching closer to him.
That knocks Harvick off by 2/100ths.
Got a little loose off too, Larry.
And that hurt him down that back straightaway.
Yep. Darrell asked earlier, and we had to go to the pits, but now the three fastest drivers, including Keselowski, have each had their fastest lap on the first lap, most everybody else on the second lap. What's up?
I just think that most drivers are trained, and you train yourself to get all you can on that first one. The second one's an insurance lap.
And don't forget, could be, you mentioned it, maybe the different air pressures that the teams are going with.
Yeah, I think that's the big thing. How much air is in the tires? They leave any room for them to expand a little bit.
Dick?
Jamie McMurray, fastest in the very first practice session today, fourth on the board at this point. How about tomorrow? That's where the money is.
Well, our Bass Pro Shop Chevy was, it was good in practice. I thought, race trim wise, that's what most guys did the first practice. I thought we were one of the better cars. And this hasn't been really a very good track for me. So the fact that we were fastest in that practice and we're pretty good in qualifying means they've given me a really good car. So we'll just have to wait and see. It's been a really fun week going turkey hunting and fishing with Johnny Morris and all the guys from Bass Pro Shops. So to have a good run would be great.
Good deal. Thank you.
Denny Hamlin, the hometown hero in the FedEx number 11 from Joe Gibbs Racing, 8 Richmond starts. He's had 2 wins and 4th place finishes in the last 4 races on the circuit, and he's up to 9th in the Sprint Cup standings.
Yeah, they just never got where they needed to be in practice. He was 21st in one practice, and I think in the other practice, the final, he was 41st quickest.
They made a change on this car. They made a few laps, and the car was up in the top 10 or so of times early in practice. They made some change on this car, and they never did get it back.
13th right now, so Hamlin will start pretty deep in this field. Krista?
Well, somebody with lots of reasons to smile right now, Elliott Sadler, back in his home state of Virginia, and it's your birthday. Happy birthday. Aww. Got a gift for us out here in this qualifying lap?
I hope so. That'd be a cool happy birthday gift, but it is neat being here at Richmond for my birthday because my whole family's with me. It's my son's first race, so he's sharing it here with us this weekend. Of course, my brother's racing tonight. And we got a cool Reynolds Wrap paint scheme on. I think the car looks great. And they're from here in Richmond, so it's a neat kind of tying us all together tonight for the birthday.
We're glad Wyatt's here. Thanks.
And Wyatt is his infant son. And here's Kyle Busch. Just won the pole for the nationwide race. He said he would have to drive a very different lap in this car to win this pole.
He was the fastest in practice at a 21:70. 21:70 will put you way back right now.
Sixth with a 46 on lap one.
Remember, he just got out of that nationwide car. Might take that first lap for him to get comfortable in this car.
Tell you what, though, he's looking pretty good. He's got a little bit of a, he's got over a tenth cushion coming off. I mean, this is going to be down in the 20s, it looks like.
This is bad fast. 21:24, Kyle Busch. To the top of the chart.
Very good. Just want to say a happy birthday to my brother Michael Curtis, inducted into the Kentucky Athletic State Hall of Fame on Wednesday night. And happy birthday today, bro.
Tell you what, he joins a pretty elite club. I think Tubby Smith, a Kentucky coach, a lot of neat people in that Hall of Fame.
Now, there are only a few race drivers, me, Danny Sullivan, and I think now Michael.
Casey Kane, David Reagan on trackside tonight. You'll see it at 11 p.m. Eastern Time, only on Speed.
Muhammad Ali is in that Hall of Fame as well.
Yeah, I was inducted. I was in 98. He was inducted. He'd been inducted in the Hall of Fame before, but he got Athlete of the Century when I was inducted in 98. So I was there that night. Awesome night.
Is Secretariat also in that Hall of Fame?
Yes.
Yes. Okay. Here's Carl Edwards in the Scots number 99. Eighth at Bristol is his best 2010 start, and he is just outside the chase right now in 13th position in the Sprint Cup standings.
And I don't think they ever did really find what they were looking for in that practice earlier as well. First lap 21:55. He'll slow down a little bit right now. 13th of the 19 cars.
Just unbelievable. The fortunes of his car and actually the Roush cars in general, that they just off just that little wee bit. It's got to be frustrating.
Dick Bergeron with the fastest man in Richmond.
Well, he was also the fastest man in practice in the Cup Series on the pole, the nationwide deal. So what is going on here with you running up front and everything you're trying?
That's what I'm supposed to do, Dick, right? That's the plan anyway. So, well, there's some good cars still coming, you know, but great job by the whole M&M's Camry team. I mean, these guys do a great job every week, and Dave's getting a lot better. These guys keep it going. So, you know, I got to do my part on the racetrack. I was a little worried the first lap. It didn't come in quite the way I wanted it to, but then the second lap it really got going. So proud of these guys. Hopefully it'll stick. If not, be a good spot.
No question about it. In this team, the driver matters a lot. A lot.
Thanks, Dick. Now watch the tracker on Montoya. Really drove it hard in one, but the ex-road racer really gets off the corner and down the straightaway well.
Yeah, that's a nice pickup there. He got out of two really smooth, and the back stayed underneath the car. If he can pick it up quick here, lost a little time there.
Not as good off four as it was off two.
Yeah. 100 slower on lap two, 21:48. Ninth fastest for Montoya, who comes in here 20th in the Sprint Cup standings.
In case you didn't understand, he does not like his car.
Terrible.
His car was just horrible.
Casey Kane.
Come on, Casey.
In that retro Budweiser scheme. It's a Richard Petty Ford, not a Junior Johnson Chevrolet, but if you squint just hard enough and the light is right, when that big Bud's coming at you, looks familiar.
It is. It's really a great tribute, not to just me as a driver, but to Hammond as the crew chief, Junior as the owner, Junior Johnson going in the Hall of Fame a couple of weeks. It's a nice tribute.
As Casey pointed out, it's a tribute to 1985, one of your championship seasons, and a race that you won during that season right here.
Well, I don't think this first lap's going to be what Casey's looking for at all. Now, he was 12th quickest in final practice, did it right late in that session, 21:56. That's 15th for this nine car so far.
He's going to pick it up, Larry.
Got some work to do through turns three and four. Picked up the throttle pretty good right there, and that's definitely going to help his cause.
That'll make a difference. Kane climbs to 11th with a 21:52, identical to Matt Kenseth's lap.
Yeah, he picked up four 100s and picked up about five spots because we have so many cars in those 50s.
Now, I'm sorry, it was identical to Kenseth's second lap. Kenseth's first lap was a couple hundredths quicker. Krista?
Well, this is not one of Tony Stewart's favorite tracks. This is his favorite track. I know you talked about a tight condition at the end of that last practice session. Were you guys able to fix that, and how are you for your qualifying run?
I don't know. I haven't been in it after the end of the last practice, so.
Did it feel better when you went back out there? How about that?
No, we're getting there. It's we Darian and these guys. We actually did a test last week, and I think that's helped us this week. And Darian's got it rotating better, so we'll see where we are for qualifying. But we're definitely going to do something different for tomorrow than we've done here in the past. But we had a good car here last year. Here I think we ran second to Mark, so. We were fast, so we'll see what's happening.
Thanks, Tony.
A little cautious optimism on Stewart's part. Scott Speed, we talk about how Phoenix is similar to this track. He qualified second at Phoenix, his best Sprint Cup start.
Pick up a little time on this lap. Car looks like it's just a little bit out, not the back end, just a little tail happy.
Through three and four pretty good that time. It's going to be a pretty good pickup and a pretty good run. Sixth quickest at a 21:45.
Excellent. He's the third quickest Toyota behind Busch and Ruderman, who have the front row right now. Brian Vickers, Robbie Gordon next. Brian Vickers completing the first of his two laps. This will be his 12th trip to Richmond. And he has two front row starts here, two poles.
Yeah, qualifying's been pretty good to Brian here, but as far as racing, he did finish seventh last September, but if you remember, that catapulted him into the chase. But if his 11 starts here, eight finishes of 24th or worse for Brian.
I remember after the race when he got into the chase, he said, "Boys, thank you so much. I've never had a car that good right here," and he got his best finish ever here.
Well, he beats his teammate Scott Speed by 4/100ths, so they are sixth and seventh. Two teammates and best friends. You wouldn't have thought so leaving Talladega, but Jeff Gordon and Jimmy Johnson have talked it over, along with car owner Rick Hendrick. Everything is fine at the top of Hendrick Motorsports.
I feel pretty safe in saying that one of the things Rick told those two boys is, you know what, I know you two guys can handle it. We got 120-something guys in those shops working on your two race cars. It's going to start bleeding down into them. Let's put this behind us and move forward.
What Rick told him was, I don't care about the replays. I don't care who cut who off. I don't care what happened yesterday. Don't let it happen tomorrow. End of story.
Good point. Here is Robbie Gordon, who is safe this week. He is in the race because he's in the top 35 by what? 2 points. He and David Gilliland keep going back and forth for that 35th position, but Robbie is there. And he's making his 20th trip to Richmond.
Not a very good first lap, 21.90 for Robbie, and this second lap's not going to do a whole lot more for him. Might pick it up a little bit, goes to 22nd, picked up 2.5 tenths, but only a spot or two.
Felt good. I don't know what it ran, but felt okay.
The BAM VIP Toyota for Robbie Gordon in the show. Tomorrow, NASCAR Race Day roars into Richmond. And on the show, Denny Hamlin, Clint Boyer, and Mark Martin live and reliving Kevin Harvick's emotional Talladega win. NASCAR Race Day, built by the Home Depot, live tomorrow, only on Speed, 5 p.m. Eastern. Elliott Sadler in that Reynolds wrap, pink and blue number 19, making his 23rd Richmond start. The best of which came for Robert Yates Racing in 2005 when he started in row 3.
Yeah, Elliott really struggled in practice. He was 32nd in one practice, and 34th in final practice. First lap not going to be very good for Elliott. 21.87. His teammate A.J. Allmendinger right now, who was the first car out, hanging there just inside the top 10 at 9th.
Allmendinger with a 21.46.
Yeah, Casey, 13th there. So,
tell you what, Elliott got through 3 and 4 and stayed up in the throttle hard, and it helped him quite a bit on lap 2.
Yeah, jumped him up to 15th. Nice move.
Another 50. 21.53.
They're up and down to the 40s and 50. That's it.
Well, Darrell, actually, McMurray is 5th at a 21.40. Paul Menard is 21st at a 21.59. Less than 2 tenths.
David Reagan in the UPS Ford climbed 4 spots in the standings to 22nd after Talladega. This is his 7th trip to Richmond, where he has a couple of top fives in the nationwide series.
And Larry, these guys constantly talk about track position, track position, track position. Certainly pit road selection helps you with that track position, but it seems like if you can start out up front and you got a pretty good pit stall, you stay up front.
Well, we've already taped our trackside show. It's going to air at 11 o'clock tonight. And Casey Kane's on there. He won his first race here when he sat on the pole, and he said all we had to do is have a decent pit stop each stop, and we just won the battle every time off pit road at that end pit box.
David Reagan looked like he had some pickup going into 1 and deep into 3, but you see the give back coming off the corner. He may pick up a spot from 24th here with this lap. He does, 21.65. Krista?
Jimmy Johnson in his race car. And do you know how many flash bulbs were popping in that when you were talking there to Jeff Gordon? What were you guys talking about? How was that phone call this week for Mr. Hendrick?
All is good. I mean, it's amazing how much
clear everyone can think on a Tuesday after something like that happens. And you know, truthfully, it was an accident or misjudgment on my behalf, closing right that he had. So you know, everything's fine, and we had a little fun with it. And we should have like thrown some punches or something. Would have made a little.
That's what I was waiting for.
Yeah, would have been cool. But actually, we're tired of all the stuff that's gone with it. So we'll let it move on, and hopefully, we don't run into each other again anytime soon.
Thanks, Jimmy.
Interesting that he says how much clearer things look on Tuesday. Tuesday is also NASCAR penalty day. They let things kind of settle and simmer for a day and a half, and then they have their meeting on penalties and infractions on Tuesdays, not right after the race. That's probably a good thing.
Well, what do we do on Tuesdays? We have our conference calls. Also, we get the video, we get the CD right of the race, so you can sit down and analyze a lot clearer what happened and what caused something once you get that video and start to watch it a little bit. I think that's where that's coming from.
Good lap for Jeff Burton. His 32nd trip in a cup car to Richmond, capital city of his home state, and he's going to be 11th with a 21.47.
Not much of a pickup from lap one to lap two, but you picked up several spots.
Not solid. Not much pickup today, Larry, but a whale of a pickup from over last year.
Yes.
We were always observing with Jeff Burton, if he could just qualify better, he would be a contender, because he had qualified very poor this year. Not the case at all. Fastest in a lot of places.
Brian Newman in the U.S. Army Medicine Chevrolet. 10 top 10 finishes in 16 Richmond starts. And he's 18th in the standings.
Chris interviewed him during one of our practice sessions. Brand new car for Stuart Haas's 39 car here this weekend. Looking on a pretty sporty first lap with this 39 car.
There, I heard that one of the crew chiefs of one of the children's cars said that they roll out a new car every third week.
Wow.
So now don't let that get back to Richard. It would be good if he knew that, but that's what they do.
Fourth for Newman. He misses third by half a hundredth.
And that's about the third quickest first lap.
He's looking for more.
We got in that throttle hard. I don't think it's going to quite be a pole, but she's going to be a good one.
Moves to the inside of row two. 21.387. To Brad Keselowski's 21.388, 1/1000th decides that spot. Got your pin on? Here's Marcus Ambrose, the Bush's Baked Beans, Kingsford Charcoal Camry. 11 points behind where he was at this stage of 2009, that is after nine races. Talladega accident was his third DNF of the year.
You know, we'd always try to qualify. We would want to be on the inside for the start of the race. Didn't want to be caught up on that outside. Boy, how that thinking has changed.
Yes, many tracks.
Picks it up a little bit inside the top 15 to 21.49, puts Marco's 14th quickest right now.
Matter of fact, we used to make deals with the guy on the inside of you. If you'll just back off and let me in, then when we get on the back straightaway or first time by, I'll move over and let you go back around. Because you just didn't feel comfortable charging off in the corner on the outside.
Tony Stewart, the Office Depot Old Spice Chevy. Tony had the first of his 37 Cup wins come here in the fall of 1999. You know, it's not June yet. Maybe it's just not time for him to win yet. It's one of those late blooming flowers every spring, or so it seems. Not that Tony would want to be compared to a flower.
Yeah, go back to last year. It was the All-Star race.
That's right.
That catapulted those guys into the summer months.
Okay, mid-May. Yeah. Let's say mid-May. Well, it's mid-May almost.
They made a change on that car. Remember, Krista was talking to him, and they put a right rear spring in the car. I know that when he went back out after that change, he didn't run as well. So see how he ends up here with this setup he's got now.
Boy, way better on the second lap.
Yeah, 21.78 on lap one. Flirting inside the top 10. If he gets off, didn't quite get off turn four that great, but he's going to end up 13th quickest at a 21.48. Picked up 3/10 on his second lap.
Dick Bergeron.
With Ryan Newman, third quick on the board so far. How much better is the car in that qualifying run than it was when you first unloaded today?
Actually, not a whole lot better. We unloaded pretty good with the Army Medicine Chevrolet, and just watching the boss qualify there, but we were pretty good in race trim, and we actually got some traffic in our qualifying lap, so I didn't expect to be 18th where we were, but didn't know if we had a shot at getting Kyle there. So a good run for the Army Medicine Chevrolet.
Okay, thank you.
Sam Hornish looking for his first top 25 start at Richmond in the Mobile One Dodge. He picked up one spot in the points at Talladega, comes in here 28th.
It's a good racetrack for Sam last year. He had top 10 finishes in both the races here in 2009. Sam was 24th in the first practice, 33rd in final practice in his 77 car. He's got teammates right now, Keselowski 4th and Kurt Busch 11th.
And he's got some work to do with a 79 on lap one.
Stepping it up this lap. Getting into three, just a little low, but it doesn't seem like it's, this is where it's hurting him. Gets in there a little low, has to pinch that corner off.
Still, he picks up about seven spots, 22nd with a 21.55.
Yeah, I think if he could have back turned three up just a little bit, it would, he would have paid better dividends coming off the corner.
Yeah, I think if he had stayed out a little wider, floated down in there out of the throttle, I think he'd have been a little quicker. But he looked like he charged in there on the bottom and hurt him on exit at four.
What's the temptation, Darrell, if you don't get off turn, don't get everything off turn one and two? Is it to just pile it in there in turn three and get it back?
Once you lose time somewhere and you know it, you start trying to make it up everywhere, and you just make it worse. You know, you got to remember, sometimes you have to slow down to go faster. This car really likes you to drive it that way. I bet this will be a pretty daggone good run.
Jeff Gordon, 35th trip to Richmond. 10 top 10 starts in a row, a couple of four poles here. He's 10th in points.
Didn't like the way it looked there.
Yeah, he was well inside the top 10 in both those practice sessions. Car way up the racetrack. Almost had to diamond it down in three and four.
Looked like it had too much front brake, almost like it slid the front tires.
28th on lap one.
Now, see, a driver like Jeff Gordon, whatever that car's doing, he will quickly adjust his driving style to complement the car.
I tell you what, he drove it down into one and two, and it stuck. He was able to keep that momentum. This is going to be a great pickup.
Not bad, not bad.
Third, 21.36.
Nice pickup, buddy.
Yeah.
Nice pickup. Can't be nervous.
Three tenths.
Fastest Chevrolet.
Had everybody nervous.
Especially after that first lap.
Yeah, I think that was just, you know, again, I think that might have been a product of air pressure, a little low maybe, or then some, and maybe a little too much brake getting in the corner, but he backed it up.
Now, we have three more of our top 35 guys to go out, including Jimmy Johnson, the 48, Bobby Labonte, and then Clint Bowyer, who was quick. Just got the report. The track temperature has really come down since this qualifying session started. In fact, we got a lot of shade starting over in turn three and four right now.
Jimmy Johnson, in his ninth season of Sprint Cup racing, he is the point leader, despite a 31st place finish last week.
And I bet you he had the 24 start side by side.
Wouldn't that be fun?
Just always works out that way.
Or nose to tail, either one. Well, it's going to take more than this lap, which is 30th quickest.
He's probably on the same setup that the 24 was. First lap, not so hot. Get it back on this one.
Yeah, they were pretty quick in the first practice. Never really got that quick of a lap in second practice.
Ooh,
but he
here we go.
Really
here
got
we go.
Off three and four. Great, a
look
lot like
this.
His teammate did.
Side by side, Johnson third, Gordon fourth. A 21.35.
The racing.
What are you, clairvoyant?
The racing gods just like it that way.
We're not done yet. Bobby Labonte, Clint Bowyer, and then knockout qualifying. Welcome back to Richmond. Kyle Busch, David Ruderman quickest as Bobby Labonte in the Racers Group Chevrolet. Labonte scored the first of his 26 cup poles here, driving for Junior Johnson in 1993.
Sitting up here watching, this is just too comical. The top three, they're holding on pit road. And so Jeff Gordon was third. And then when Johnson, when Jimmy beat him, they rolled Jeff Gordon's car out of line. And you can go now. The 48
the
beat you.
The aggravation just continues.
The 48 beat you.
Dick?
Well, Jeff, going to start side by side with your teammate tomorrow night. What do we make of that?
Well, I'm more excited about you having a shot starting in the top five, you know, if that time holds up. You know, when I saw everybody picking up so much, I just wasn't sure if those last couple runs we made in practice, if we went in the right direction. But the car was really good and got in the corners deep. And, you know, the 48 didn't have a great day, but he qualified real well. Same old thing for them. And you know, they're going to be tough all night, and so we'll have a lot of fun out there racing with them like we have been, and hopefully it's us battling for the win. You know, I don't think anybody would like to see that more than us.
I think the fans would love to see the two of you guys come off turn four side by side for the win. Stick around tomorrow night, NASCAR on Fox. You may see that. Who knows?
Thanks to Clint Bowyer. Was quick in practice. He's never started better than 12th here until tomorrow night. He'll line up 10th with a 21-42.
Had a pretty good run going. Wasn't quite as good in 3 and 4 as he was down in 1 and 2.
Yeah, I lost it on 4. Felt like I had a decent lap there. Sorry.
When Bowyer won this race 2 years ago, he started 31st, the worst of any Richmond winner. So he'll line up 10th. Back to Dick Berggren.
With Jimmy Johnson and his Jeff Gordon walked away. Jimmy Johnson grabbed his water bottle and made a mock effort to throw it at Jeff Gordon. You guys are going to start side by side tomorrow night. What can we expect from you?
That's great. I hope to have it on camera. I mean, everybody wants some controversy. Maybe I throw my Gatorade out and that'll start something and get everybody talking some more. But, you know, aside from having a little fun there, great lap for us. We kind of found our way late in practice. Chad made some great decisions on what we needed for qualifying, and I put down. Now, first lap was a little sketchy. Second lap was good, and I got a start spot.
And Jimmy Johnson has won 3 of the last 6 here at Richmond.
Thanks, Dick. Here's the little bit of playfulness you saw earlier. Now I'm not really going to throw it because it's full.
He used a word that my girls use all the time. Sketchy.
Sketchy.
Yeah, it's a little sketchy out there.
All right, we're into knockout qualifying. David Stremme in the Air National Guard. Ford first up, 21.87 on lap 1, 21.73 on lap 2. 3 drivers are going home today. Up next, Terry Cook, Tony Raines, Joe Nemechek. Speed's coverage of Sprint Cup qualifying in Richmond presented by Subway Restaurants. So many $5 footlong subs to choose from. Enjoy amazing value at Subway all day, every day. And brought to you by Johnsonville. Sausage is all we do. And by AutoZone for the auto parts, accessories, and advice you need. Get in the zone. AutoZone. Terry Cook and the Atlantic Company Dodge. They have struggled to make races. And a 21.75 on lap 1, going to be the quickest of 2 laps for the former star of the Camping World Truck Series. So Stremme is first and Cook is second in knockout qualifying so far.
Yeah, I mean, my first intuition would be that a 70 is not very good. But when I look at our go-home guys in the final practice session, the fastest was Joe Nemechek of all the cars, and he was only 25th quickest as far as all the competitors. So don't know that those are bad times just yet for these guys.
Joe Nemechek won this race from the outside pole 7 years ago.
I think he was driving the 25 car.
Correct.
For Rick Henry.
That's right. 6 top 10 starts here, including that outside pole start. Joe has made every race. In 2010, he's 39th in the Sprint Cup standings. First lap, better than Stremme or Cook with a 72.
I think you'll see Joe pick it up quite a bit on lap 2. He was by far the fastest of the go-go homers. In fact, he's flirting with a top 10 run right now.
I'd say it was like top 5 earlier.
Oh, boy, you saw a glimpse of front row Joe going into turn number 3, but he ends up 11th. Strong effort for a car that did not put on a lot of laps in practice. 21.45, 11th.
Yeah, he drove it in so hard into turn 3, the car actually washed up the racetrack, and I think he just really started losing traction on the exit of the corner.
When you do that, you know you can't wait, though. You've got to get back to the gas if you're going to try to make any kind of time at all. That's why you get all loose and squirrely like that.
Next up is Tony Raines, former star of the ASA series and the NASCAR Busch series, trying to make his first start in 2010. He has 9 cup starts here, 15 in what's now the Nationwide Series, and 2 truck races. Little Joe's Auto Sales Toyota.
You know how you know these cars are sticking to the racetrack pretty darn good? You don't see many of them sideways. I mean, you see them wiggle. You see them move. You don't see anybody go off in the corner and just absolutely spin out. you know.
21.93. Reigns has got to go. You see that green line? That's where Joe Nemechek is. That is not where Reigns needs to go to make the race, but to lock in. That is the lock-in point right there where Joe Nemechek is. And what it means is Tony Reigns, 21.78, will lock in Joe Nemechek, who is 11th.
Now, here's what's amazing. Darrell and I talk so much about how many guys we have in the 40s and 50s, but when you look at our go or go homers, aside from Joe Nemechek, every one of those guys are in the 70s.
21.73, 21.73, 76, 78, just hundreds.
Very close.
Hundreds away from making hundreds.
Georgia's Reed Sorensen started fifth here in 2008 in this race. Finished 12th. He also has three top 10s in the Nationwide Series. He's trying to make his second race of 2010 for Braun Racing.
I think he was bad fast in qualifying for the Nationwide race.
Second. Outside pole,
yeah, outside pole, I believe he is.
Yep.
He was fourth of the go or go home cars in practice earlier today. You can see all the shade that started to really get down in turn three and four, and that just gains grip.
So now 36th where the green line is. That is the lock-in point. And Sorensen's in. He beats David Stremme. So with a 21.67, he will race tomorrow night.
We're in right now.
And the bottom three are Stremme, Cook, and Reigns.
So now, as important as qualifying is here, you heard the crew chief tell him 67 we're in. The message there is go ahead and run this second lap, but don't bust your tail doing it.
Well, he picks up to a 63, and that moves him up the board to 33rd.
Yeah, that's just a little bit better pit selection, and you know, makes you feel better too. Plus, you know, driver can breathe on that second lap.
Six drivers to go. Three drivers will go home in knockout qualifying. Max Pappas, after a tough qualifying effort, we knew he'd drive it hard into turn one, and oh boy, did he.
Way out there wide, makes that late entry into the corner. You can see the left front wheel
just locked up.
Locked it up, and that's just carried it in a little too much. Cranked a little rear brake in, it might have helped a little bit.
That killed the first lap. The second one was better at a 21.83. It locks David Stremme into the race, and the bottom three are now Terry Cook, Tony Reigns, and Max Pappas. Mike Bliss on the speedway. This is his seventh trip to Richmond in the Cup car. Talladega was his first top 10 finish in the Cup Series since 2005. Driving the 09 for James Finch.
He's in.
Whoa.
He's in, though. The first lap locked.
Don't wreck it, man. You're in.
There you go.
21.66, 35th overall. And Bliss is in. And the bottom three remain Cook, Reigns, and Pappas.
They got loose that second lap into three.
He will race tomorrow night.
Now, David Gilliland is next. We've talked about how he is just 2 points behind Robbie Gordon, as you look at Kyle Busch, who currently is fastest. So Gordon is in and Gilliland is out. What did Robbie Gordon run? Robbie ran a 21.66. And was locked into the field. Let's see how David does. He has to qualify on time, and right now the time to beat is Terry Cook's 21.75.
Shout out to Kyle Busch. Just think about it. He raced last night. He's racing tonight. He's going to race tomorrow night. Where's he racing?
I'd say
Sunday.
There's a chance he may be racing somewhere Sunday.
Well, when's the truck race?
He's not going to Kansas to run the truck race. I do know that.
Looks like David Gilliland needs to pick it up. Yeah, he's a 21.85. So Gilliland needs to find at least a 10th in the Taco Bell Ford.
This car looked like it had the push loose look down in turn one and two. Didn't turn, didn't want to snap with him just a little bit.
Coming back.
It may be enough here, though, on lap two.
Yes, barely. 21.74, Gilliland's in.
Good job.
And at 21.75, Terry Cook is still in the bottom three with Tony Reigns and Max Pappas.
Mike, the reason we're still seeing cars with trouble off of two, because the sun is still brightly shining as it sets off of turn two over there. but turn three and four, the reason guys are starting to really make up time on that end of the speedway is you can see it's all in shade for the most part.
Well, I tell you one reason Kyle Busch is watching that scoreboard. This car right here, Dave Blaney, we know it, especially at a short track. He has a way of reaching down in that barrel and finding a lot more than you think he can find.
Yeah, he was third at Bristol, and that got a lot of people's attention.
He has a second row start here. Back driving the 77 in 2002. This is his 20th trip to Bristol. Let's see what this Prism Motorsports Camry can do as it broadslides off the corner.
Not good at all on his first lap.
He has to beat 21.75.
The lock up in that left front getting into three. So he's driving hard, Larry. Loose in. Little brake smoke getting in the corner.
Not enough. 21.93, lap one. Not quick enough.
Should be a much better second lap. He'll tighten her up.
Didn't get off turn two very well. That hurt him all the way down, even though that's a short back straightaway. He locks the left front up, getting in the corner both times in turn three.
This could be good news for Terry Cook.
I think it is.
And it is. Cook is in at 21.75. Blaney goes home with a 21.84. He is the first driver knocked out.
And that is a huge surprise because normally Dave Blaney finds enough to get in the show, a lot of times jump up there in the top five or 10.
Max is saying, man, I beat Blaney.
But Max is not out of the race yet. He is on the bubble right now with a 21.83. Blaney was slower, so Pappas has a little bit of breathing room. The bottom two, Tony Raines and Max Pappas, with Michael McDowell and Casey Mears to go. McDowell's three starts at this track, 29th, 38th, 41st, as he tries to make his eighth race of 2010.
And he was the slowest of the go-go-homers in that final practice session. His teammate, Dave Blaney, we know is already out of the show for tomorrow night.
That's not a good lap.
McDowell has to beat 21.78. The first lap will not do it. It's over 22 seconds.
You see National Day of Prayer on the hood of the car. That's one of their sponsors for this weekend. Is love to see the car get in the race.
Darrell, I don't know that this is even.
Yeah, it's not close.
He needs 3/10.
Not close.
And McDowell is in the bottom two. Max Pappas goes home. You see Pappas on the left of the screen. His 21.83 falls short. McDowell is a 21.80. That locks Tony Raines into the race.
From a 22.28, Larry, to a 21.80. That's sucking it up right there.
Well, the crew chief told him down the backstretch, got to have some more. Got to go or go home.
Got to wait on this one.
And now we're down to the final car, and it's Michael McDowell or Casey Mears, who has climbed into the Tommy Baldwin car, number 36, for his 15th try at Richmond. Casey trying to make his second race of the season. He was in the show at Bristol.
How unpredictable is qualifying? I don't care who's out there on the racetrack. You see Kyle Busch, he knows it ain't over till it's over, because anybody can pull a surprise.
21.80 is the time to beat. And Mears looks like he is going to handily be in the field in lap one. He's in. 31st for Casey Mears with a 21.58. And that means that both Prism Motorsports cars, McDowell and Blaney, and Max Pappas will be the cars that head home. And look at Mears on lap two. He was up to the top 10 going into the corner. And
good
he's going to end
good
up
job.
Top 15 for Baldwin, 13th for Casey Mears with a 21.45.
That is a very
great
good
run for them.
Excellent.
Casey Mears needed that. Tommy Baldwin Racing needed that.
Definitely.
Kyle Busch and David Ruderman are the first all Toyota front row since Chicagoland last year. Krista?
Two qualifying sessions today, two poles for Kyle Busch. Were you surprised that speed held? You went out relatively, I guess, mid-pack. Were you surprised it lasted?
A little bit, not too much. You know, we had a great race car in practice, so Dave and the guys did a really awesome job on our M&M's Camry, and you know, real proud to be able to put the Camry on the pole for the first time for Dave, and first time I know for me. I don't win very many poles, so first one here at Richmond. But look forward to tomorrow. You know, I think we've got a pretty good race car as well too. I know there's a couple guys behind us that that'll be pretty good too. So we'll just have to try to hold them off.
We joked about that. You said you don't win many poles, but you win pretty much everything else that you touch. How much does this mean to do this for Dave?
Well, it means a lot. You know, Dave's gone through a lot of criticism so far this year, and I really enjoy working with him, and I feel like we've done a nice job at,
getting the finishes that we've gotten so far. Yeah, some haven't gone our way a lot. We shouldn't have gotten. So, you know, it's nice to come out here, though. This is one of my best tracks, one of my favorite tracks, and I like coming out here and running well. And so just glad it stuck and we were able to get a pole.
All right. Thanks, Kyle. Congratulations.
It's the first time Kyle Busch has ever won the Cup and Nationwide poles on the same weekend. More from Richmond after this. Kyle Busch has won his first Richmond pole in his 11th race here. He'll start from the pole in the Crown Royal presents the Heath Calhoun 400 tomorrow night. David Rudeman gets his fifth front row start in his Cup career.
I like that second row.
I'll tell you, that's going to be interesting. Watch those two guys. But we talked about all during this qualifying session. But when you look back there at our go or go home guys, Tony Raines makes the show at a 21.787. Michael McDowell misses it at a 21.803.
16 one-thousandths made the difference of who raced and who went home.
Tell you what, the biggest surprise to me, Denny Hamlin, this has been his racetrack. He's going to start back in the 30th position.
So congratulations to Kyle Busch, the pole winner. We'll see you on Fox tomorrow night with coverage of the Heath Calhoun 400.